Central Park North by the Fat Jones and Mel Lewis Band of New York. They were famous back in the 1970s. And I mention that just because the whole album is themes that have to do with the place, Central Park. And of course, if you try to park your vehicle anywhere close, you're probably in a tow-away zone. And that's what that one is all about. So it's a real fun boogaloo style blues. That's a technical term. It featured Bridget Haftellen on the tenor saxophone. Brian Caricato from right here in Farmville, Virginia, on the bass trombone. And Nathan Hopkins from the metropolis of Martinsville back there on the trumpet. So we've got just a really great lineup of music for you tonight. For the next one, we'll turn to a little bit more traditional jazz style. This one is entitled Girl Talk, and it was written by a composer named Neil Hefti, who was a trumpet player in Count Basie's orchestra, and he wrote a lot of great tunes for the Count Basie band back in the late 1950s, early 1960s. This one he composed for a studio orchestra. It was for a movie about the actress Jean Harlow, and in a bio-type movie of her. And it was just one of the tunes that they used in there. And the lyric theme, you won't hear words, our version is instrumental, but the lyric theme is one surrounding just sort of that mystery, how men just have no clue what girls are really talking about. And so to convey that message to you tonight, we're going to feature our lead alto saxophone player, Mr. Reagan Warner from Powhatan, Virginia, on the solo section in Neil Hefti's Girl Talk. will proceed along, changing the style once again. The next number that we have comes, I think this emerged as a great jazz tune with the Stan Kenton Band back in the 1950s. We don't have their original arrangement, but we've got a really nice arrangement of it. The title is Malagueña, and it has this Spanish minor key and scale relationship in there with the harmonies that I think will set it off a lot from the other songs that we play. It's also in a real fast triple meter, which means that we have to stay on our toes rhythmically and press the beat forward a lot while we play this one. It's really exciting to play. We'll hear from a group of soloists, and I'll tell you who they were after they do their thing. This one is Malagueña.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Malagueña. Longwood University Jazz Ensemble. Let's see, that featured a lot. It started off with the groove being laid down by Chris Diffin on the piano. All the way through featured the drumming of Sam Harrison at the trap set. And then our soloists over here included Bridget Halfdellen again. Also Ian Ray of Richmond, Virginia on the guitar. Brianna Anderson of Lunenburg County, Virginia on the trumpet. And also Melanie Gray from Woodbridge on the alto saxophone. I'd like to take a second just to do what I forgot to do at the beginning of the program. Not only is it great to have a lot of people in the house tonight, and thank you for coming out to share the music with us, I'd like to welcome people that are watching the stream. This concert is being streamed as we've been doing at Longwood ever since the COVID days. It's been a great thing. And I notice sometimes that as the weeks pass after a concert, we post the concerts on YouTube for a little while, and we really pilot a lot of viewers and listeners that even maybe couldn't make it tonight, but I'd like to just tell those folks we're happy to have them watching us tonight and excited about the music that we have to play. There's something that comes next on the program. I gotta look and see what it is. Oh yeah, one of my all-time favorite, this is what we're doing tonight, is Dr. Kinzer's favorites. That's the theme. And this one just about takes the cake for me personally, for a jazz band arrangement. This comes from the Count Basie Band, and it's a piece of music that really belongs to Duke Ellington, so how can you beat that? It's an arrangement by one of Count Basie's saxophone players, Frank Foster, of the famous Duke Ellington tune, In a Mellow Tone. And this tune just really swings all the way through, particularly in this arrangement from Frank Foster. Our performance of it will feature this Chris Diffin at the piano, also Mr. Ryan Stock, you thought I was going to miss that, from Midlothian, Chesterfield area in Virginia on the trombone, and it will feature the drumming toward the end of Sam Harrison at the trap set. So this is In a Mellow Tone. Thank you. Well, we're halfway through our program. Already?
Yep.
So, one thing that I want to communicate this evening is this is my final concert on campus, you know, spring or fall semester concert. I think this is number 61 for me over the course of the whole career. So there have been a few, and sometimes they kind of run together a little bit when I have my anxiety dreams about being in the middle of one and nothing is going right. Wait a minute, that's not going to happen tonight. We still have work to do. But before we set about the second half of this one, I would just like to say, like to make it clear to everybody that it has just been a joy to lead this band for the last 31 or 2 years. And it's just been terrific to work at Longwood. I've been so privileged and lucky to get a job in my life, and my mother thinks that still. But just really lucky to have a job where sometimes my friends come up to me and say, "Man, your job looks like fun." And, you know, it really has been. And just to be able to do the thing you wanted to do, you know, in your life for all that career is really a pretty special thing. And Longwood has just been a very special place. And I certainly think about it a lot and, you know, don't take it for granted at all. This group group is, thank you. This particular group has been really wonderful to work with. The group over all the years has been really wonderful to work with. The Longwood Jazz Band did exist for 13 years or so before I ever arrived here, and it flourished and thrived back in the 1980s, and I feel like it's going to continue to flourish and thrive. And I'm very happy to announce that Dr. David Moore is going to join our staff in the fall, and he will be the new director of the Longwood Jazz Ensemble. So I hope that everybody will look forward to many concerts to come. And I'll certainly be up there with Gordon Ring in the balcony. We've already straightened that out. We've got our spots picked for the next bunch of years. So anyway, just want you to know that this has been a real blast. We're going to continue to have the fun right here tonight. The next tune that we'll play comes from the Maynard Ferguson group. And this one, our lead trumpet player, Brianna, had to talk me into this one, putting this one on the list. But I really like it. It has a lot of energy. It's entitled Fire Shaker, and it features several people in the band. You'll hear from Chris Diffin, and Brianna will play on this one also, and if there are other soloists, I'll inform you about that later. This is Fire Shaker. Thank you. Yasmin's going to join us for the terrific tune, The Best Is Yet to Come.
Thank you.
So Maynard Ferguson had a keyboard player for a little while named Matt Harris. And when he was working on that band, and he's had also a long career writing tunes for the jazz ensemble, but he really made his mark writing pieces of music for the Maynard Ferguson group. And we're going to turn to one of Matt Harris's original pieces for our next selection. This is not one that he wrote for the Maynard Ferguson band, but it's one that he published, and it's been out there for, maybe a couple of decades. It has an infectious beat that is derived from New Orleans-style street beat, is what they call it, or the street music that you might hear at a Mardi Gras parade. The title of it is Matitude, which, of course, is just a pun on the guy's name, the composer's name. Our performance of it will feature Reagan Warner playing on alto saxophone, and then you'll hear the rhythm that's laid down by Ian Ray, Dion Hansley on the bass from Hampton, Virginia, and also Sam Harrison on the drums. This is Matitude. Thank you. Thank you. Matitude with Reagan Warner, Sam and Dion on the clave rhythm. So once again, I'd like to thank you for coming out this evening, Thursday. Happy Pi Day, by the way. It's March the 14th. I've seen a couple of t-shirts to that effect there. We certainly want to support our brethren in the world of math. That's important to them. So anyway, you know, it's just wonderful that you'll be able to come to Jarman Auditorium on a weeknight in March. It does feel like spring today, so glad we had the title Spring Concert on our little program there. But I know that you're making an effort to come share the music with us, and we really appreciate it a lot. We've enjoyed it very much this semester working on this music, and we do have one more piece of music for you, and it's a little more recent than some of the other ones that we have played, and I think probably it needs not much of any introduction. You'll hear some of the same soloists that you've heard in some of the other ones. And so here's another one that's really fun to play. We'll be right back. Reagan Warner, Ethan Cuttington on the trombone, and Bridget Halfdan on the tenor. The Longwood University Jazz Ensemble. Thank you. We don't have an encore, that was it. So, thank you once again for being here tonight. We'll look forward to seeing you again soon. We will appear 1 month from this week at the Tin Pan Restaurant in Richmond. So, what's up?
So, we really appreciate Dr. Pinder and really sad to see him go and retire, which he most definitely deserves. But we also wanted to make sure that he knew that he was so very appreciated working with us the past. I've been in this since I was a freshman and I was a junior, and a lot of us have worked with him for so many semesters, so he's just very appreciative. We just got you a card.
Lots of signatures. The first one says, "Hey, old boring dude, it's been a blast." So, thank you guys. Thank you very much.